Factories, and it began the career of the pigtailed youngster known as Little Mary Decker.
I can remember when I was in grade school, we used to play chase, you know, where the girls chase the boys or the boys chase the girls, etc. And I could always outrun the boys. It was kind of boring. I like running fast. Sometimes I see other people running and they look so uncomfortable, and I always think to myself, if I ever felt like I looked that way, that this wouldn't be what I would be doing.
With her narrow hips and what's been called a perfect running form, she is the best middle distance runner in America. That means she doesn't run the sprint or the marathon, but the distances in between. She holds the U.S. record in every distance from 800 to 10,000 meters, and the world record in the mile. 5 years ago in Finland, when she won the first world championships in her favorite races, the 1500 and 3000 meters, the press dubbed her twin victories the double decker.
She's going to do it. Mary does it. She's the best in the world.
But for all her fame, nowhere is Mary appreciated more than at her home track in Eugene, Oregon, training ground for a generation of runners. And no one is a bigger fan than her husband, discus thrower Richard Slaney, known as Britain's strongest man. Lately, he's been helping her train for what could be the biggest challenge of her career. 2 years after giving birth to a daughter named Ashley, Mary is headed for Korea to run in her most important Olympics. It was on the track here in Eugene that Mary Decker Slaney broke five U.S. or world records in the last half dozen years. But that is not enough. She still wants an Olympic gold, the only major honor that's eluded her since she started running. In 1972, she was too young to try out for the Olympics in Munich. In 76, shin splints kept her from entering the games in Montreal. In 80, the U.S. boycott ended all hopes of winning in Moscow. And in 1984, at the Los Angeles Olympics, there was that awful moment that all of us watched on television. It had been billed as Mary's moment, the 3,000 meter, hyped in the headlines as a match race between Mary, the season champion, versus Zola Budd, the South African teenager turned British citizen who ran barefoot.
There was this little farm girl, quote unquote, from South Africa, running against the favorite, quote unquote, from the U.S. The Olympics were in the U.S. in L.A., and it was a good story.
Good for the press, but full of pressure for Mary. Cast in the role of the heavy in this Olympic drama, she found herself compromising on her running strategy. Typically, when you're in a tight pack, you use your arms or your elbows to keep others from cutting in front of you.
I was afraid to touch her because of all the media stuff that had gone on prior to the race. I thought, well, if I touch her, people are going to say I pushed her or something.
Officially, you must be one full stride ahead before you change lanes. But when Zola took the lead, Mary says she started edging inside too soon.
Zola Budd has the lead. When they cross the line this time around, there will be three laps to go. With a barefoot Mary Decker falls down. Mary Decker falls down in the infield.
The whole world gasped as Mary fell, her hip injured, her Olympic dream destroyed. She left the field in agony, crying, carried off by Richard, then her boyfriend. And in an act that would be widely viewed as unsporting, she refused Zola Budd's apology.
I don't think there's any question that she was in the wrong. And I do hold her responsible for what happened because I don't feel that I did anything wrong. Hopefully the injury will heal in time so I can go over to Europe and race.
A day later, Olympics officials said Budd was not responsible and ruled there had been no foul. And 4 years later, while Mary maintains her position, she says she holds no grudge.
You don't think she did it on purpose?
Oh, God, no.
The accident that probably cost her a medal in Los Angeles made Mary hungry for new victories.
Yes, I gotta have faith.
She dug down deep and hit the circuit in 1985, winning every race she ran. Competing against familiar runners like Budd, She set new American records in the 800 meters, the 1,000, the 3,000, and the 5,000. And she ran the mile in 4 minutes, 16 seconds, 71. A world record that still stands. A year after her collision with Bud in Los Angeles, she was burning up the tracks around the world.
There are a number of words that have been used to describe your dedication to your sport. Compulsion, concentration, dedication, paranoia. Which ones are real?
I'm dedicated. I'm definitely dedicated. I don't know if compulsiveness. Do you think I'm compulsive
in my sport? I think you missed a couple out. Like obsession.
I think obsession's closer than compulsiveness. Paranoia. The only thing I can say that the word paranoia relates to me in the sport is I'm paranoid of injury.
For a world-class athlete, she is surprisingly fragile. She even trims her shoelaces so they won't trip her. Mary is injury-prone for the same reason she is so speedy. She literally runs differently from other people. Most runners' feet land fairly level on the ground, so the arch absorbs much of the stress. Not Mary.
I'm a toe runner. I run more on the front of my foot. And the way I run is really efficient. But there is a drawback. The way I run also puts a lot of stress on the lower portions of my legs. And that's where I've had all my problems.
She has been called a perfect runner from head to knees, and glass from there on down. In all, she's had repeated injuries to both shins, both Achilles tendons, her knee, her calf, and her hip.
Can we see the scars?
Well, sure. My shins, for example, I've had surgery twice on both of these. And then this was the outside one. And then this Achilles tendon one was the first one in 80. And then the last two you can barely see.
You've been through a tremendous amount of pain over the years with this, haven't you?
Yes. A certain amount, but I can say that none of my injuries or surgeries have been more painful than having the baby.
After her string of victories in early 85 and facing what she called an insignificant year for competition, Marianne Richards scheduled a baby into her training calendar. Professionally, it was somewhat risky. Mary told me her own obstetrician had little information about the effects of strenuous exercise on herself or the baby. But Mary remained dedicated, refusing to let her pregnancy slow her down.
Did you want to push yourself harder than the doctor or your husband would let you?
Of course. For the first 3.5 months, I did a lot of aerobic exercises and bouncing and bounding. And later when she started growing, I started having a lot of cramping when I would run. I'd run for half mile or a mile and I'd just get these really severe cramps and I would have to stop.
Together, Mary and Richard agreed to cut down her training time to the minimum. A difficult sacrifice for a woman as committed as Mary to maintaining her peak form.
The baby was born. How many days did you hold off before you ran?
I waited 6 days before I went out to jog, and I went for a whole mile without a cramp, and it was great. Within a week, I was up to running 6 miles, and that following week, I started doing all my exercises and, you know, just everything.
As usual, Mary pushed too hard and had to take 3 months off to recover. But soon, her body healed and she got back to her running size of 5'6", 105 pounds. She was ready to try out for the Olympics. But the biggest mystery was still to come. How would childbirth affect her performance? Other famed runners, including Evelyn Ashford and Ingrid Christensen, have gotten faster since having babies. Are they exceptions or the norm?
Has being a mother made you faster or stronger?
I don't know. I do know in training that this year I feel stronger than I've ever felt. It could be because of being a mother, and maybe not.
But while Mary can't yet say whether childbirth has changed her physiologically, her husband is convinced it has affected her psychologically.
It stops you thinking about track and field. You know, you think about Sesame Street and Winnie the Pooh and, you know, when I was training a lot and then she was training, it would be track and field all the time. Now, you know, you have to worry about when Ashley's going to nap.
Those closest to Mary say her current strength is a direct result of her new stability. A happy home life, just a short drive from the track, an adoring husband who celebrated her double world championships with this license plate, and a comfortable contract, mainly with Nike, that earns her some $500,000 a year. And with all that going for her, she has been able to keep her sights fixed on her Olympic running goal. In early July, Mary easily won the 1500 and 3000 meter races in Indianapolis to qualify for the Olympics. And while the old Mary was in top running form, the new Mary was equally evident.
Catherine, there's one thing I need to do. I need to say hello to Ashley. Hi, Ash, I miss you.
Well, let's get back quickly to the race. Regina Jacobs gave you a good push.
Yeah, it was great. It felt really good.
For two decades, Mary Decker Slaney has dominated women's track in this country. Her extraordinary talent and her grit have made her a champion, despite layers of scar tissue and several Olympic-sized disappointments. But for this woman who says she gets grumpy when she doesn't run, this Olympics, this time, she seems ready.
That is quite a woman. You know, there's a report now, as you know, Lynn, that she's suffering from some kind of infection. What's that going to do?
Well, it seems to be something she picked up in Europe during some of the European races, but she has been back home in Eugene. She's been on antibiotics. We spoke with her manager today. He says she is feeling fine, and they do not expect this to affect her ability to compete. And on Monday, she's off to Seoul.
And how do you think she will do there? What's your opinion?
I have opinions, but mostly I talk to experts for these opinions. And at the moment, the experts are saying that she is the favorite in the 3,000, which is her race, and she is not the favorite at the moment in the 1500, but she is going to compete in both of them anyway.
And could win both of them. Thank you.
She sure could.
Thank you.